Hi guys, this is Jason here from the Nathaniel School of Music, and in this tutorial, let's learn how to form scales beyond the major scale. The major scale is something you would have probably used and heard of and been able to form with all the theory, circle of fifths and whatnot, but let's look at other scales. There's a lot more to learn, so let's get started right away. And before we do, it'll be great if you could subscribe to our YouTube channel, give us a thumbs up, and all those other nice things. Okay, so let's get started. G major is what I'm going to choose, or G as the home base, or the root, or the sa if you're learning Indian music, or the tonal center. You have all sorts of words for it. I may just call it the root, or the sa, or whatever. Okay, so let's first build the G major scale together. Okay, so a scale is actually formed with a collection of intervals. Okay, you may argue, yeah, it's a collection of sounds, rather it's a collection of notes. But I would prefer to say intervals, because an interval is the sound of a sound created when two musical notes are observed together by the human ear. So if you take G and then cluster it with maybe the D, you're hearing D with reference to G, or because of G. That's why we respect that root note as the main note of the scale. So G, D, right? So this is what we call as intervals. Okay, so D is not just a note of the D major scale. It is the fifth of the D major scale. Also what we call as the perfect fifth. So root, fifth. So with pretty much all the scales you would form, barring one or two, every scale is going to have a root, and the root is going to be one of the 12 keys in music. A, A sharp or B flat, B, C, C sharp or D flat, D, D sharp or E flat, E, F, F sharp or G flat, G, G sharp or A flat, A, and so on and so forth. So you'll have any scale. A scale is an assortment of intervals, while a key is one of the 12 ways or one of the 12 roots you can give to that particular scale. So a major scale can be played or can be demonstrated or can be performed in 12 keys, right? Because there are 12 notes in music. So if I take the G as one of my roots or one of my tonal centers, the G major scale is formed with a collection of intervals. First off, you have the root, G, which is self-explanatory. It's just the root or the name of the scale, and that's the sound you're hearing. Then you have the fifth. So when you're trying to play this fifth, always try to get it with respect to the root. So even you could also train your ear. Root fifth, sa pa, G D, da da, and then try to play it. So that's a good challenge. Sing it, la la, and now play it, la la, and then see if you're right, which I am, luckily. Okay, so now the other note which is very, very important to build a scale is the third. Okay. In this case, the third is B. We call it a major third. La, la, G, B. Now, however, you can also alter this third. You can get another tonality by going down a step. Root, minor third. We call that a minor third or a komal gha if you're looking at it in the Indian music theory perspective. So, sa and pa or the root and fifth are consistent. You have the gha or the third being major third or minor third. You have those variants. Major third, minor third, G, B flat. Okay? You see, the minor third has a very different emotion. So if you build a scale where the minor third exists, it's going to definitely be a very, very different sound. It's going to be a very much more melancholic emotion, or maybe sadder, or maybe braver. You know, while the major third will be a little bit more uplifting, a little bit more positive, and so on and so forth. So what about the other intervals? So in the G major scale, we already have a few more, right? You have the A, which is the major second. You have the C, which is the perfect fourth. Then you have the E, which is the major sixth. La la. And you have the F sharp. So the F sharp is, you could say, the most tense of the lot. See, it feels a little uneasy, right? So a major scale seems to give us all these tonalities. You have the root, the fifth, you have the third. You could also count the octave, which is G to G. So those are what we call as your resolutions. Those are the intervals which sound stable to the ear. It just feels normal or not so uneasy. And then you have what we call as the anticipations, which are the major second. See, it feels like it's a bit unstable, but not very chaotic and not so annoying or not so tense or not so scary. Similarly, you have the perfect fourth, which again is nice, but it's still unstable because it wants to go to the third. Maga. Then you have the sixth, which tends to resolve to the fifth. Dha-pa. And then you have the seventh, which is also, which is a lot more tense, but you can resolve it. So you can always resolve these anticipations or tensions, as I call them, to some other note, which will end up being a resolution. So let's recap. Major scale intervals: root, fifth, third. These are all your resolutions. Then we have your anticipations: major two, perfect fourth, major sixth, major seventh. Of course, that's the octave. So if we have to just practice singing them: G, D, that's the perfect fifth. G, D, G, B, that's the major third. Sa, ga, G, G, root octave. All resolutions. Now if I do the anticipations: G, C, sa, ma. And then re, sa re, major second, sa re, perfect fourth again, sa ma, perfect fourth, resolving to the major third, sixth, sa da, major sixth, resolving to the perfect fifth, and lastly, major seventh, resolving to the octave, if you will, right? Now, the major scale already provides us with so many intervals. Now, we want to go beyond. That's what this lesson is about. So, if you take just the first five notes, let's just study the first five notes. G, A, B, C, D, C, B, A, G. These are all the major scale notes for the first five notes. Now, let's mess with this a bit and create a few more options for us, which will build us new scales. So if you take major scale, let's mess with the third, which is now the major third, B. How do I change that? I could convert it to the minor third, which is B flat. Immediately you get a more melancholic or a little more sadder kind of a feeling. Okay, so that's your minor third. How do you form it? Major third down a step. So the assumption here is, please know your major scales, or I hope that you know your major scales when you're following through this lesson. So major third, minor third. Got that? Try to write it down for all the other keys as well. That'll be very helpful. And then you'll also have the major second, which can become a minor second, which is quite cool. So now you could combine that major second with minor second with other permutations of the third, the fourth, and the fifth. So if I take major scale, now if I alter the second, Immediately you get a very different tonality. It almost feels as though this music is coming from the east, you know, as opposed to the west, you know, which this seems to come from the west, while it's more like the Middle Eastern kind of sound. Very beautiful, right? And if you combine that with the minor third, what is the minor third again? B flat, right? So the minor second A becomes A flat. Very tense, but very beautiful at the same time. So you go, you may also remember. You can build a lot of interesting riffs and phrases with that interval. So what if we combine a minor second with a minor third? Sounds very Egyptian or very Spanish, I guess. So you're basically trying to play with this. So major second, major third by the book, becoming minor third, becoming minor second. And what we do with the fourth, which is C, is you can't bring it down, because if you bring it down a step, as we learn in a major scale, the major scale has no gaps between the third and the fourth note, between the ga and the ma, there's no gap, right? So you can't really flatten the fourth, you sharpen the fourth. So I will sharpen the C to C sharp. So whenever you flatten something, in Indian music we say komal, you're going down by one. Whenever you sharpen something, we say tivra, where you sharpen it. It becomes very dreamy and very mystical. So this is the major scale with a sharp four. But then you can also do it with a flat 3 and a sharp 4. Or maybe a flat 2, a flat 3 and a sharp 4. Ah, it's quite exciting. Or back to major if you want. Right? So the same thing you can do beyond the pa or beyond the fifth. So you want to establish these pillars first, which I think are important. You have your root, you have your fifth, and you have your octave. That's your base. It's your home base. And now you build around that. So now if you have the major sixth, which is part of the major scale, you flatten that to the minor sixth, which is very interesting. Similarly, if you have the major 7th, which is part of the major scale, you can flatten that to the minor 7th. So that's flat 6, flat 7. So flat 7 is like a very Mixolydian sound. Or with a flat 6. Very Celtic. You see, I've already built a 7-note scale, which is not major, very unique and very usable, right? Right, or you could form maybe. So let's observe what intervals I've used to form this scale. This is major. And now what is this? Flat 2 or komal re. Normal major 3rd. Normal perfect 4th. Normal perfect 5th. So you get that cluster. And then you have minor 6th, making it very mysterious, major 7th. So we've just you can consider this scale to be the major scale with a flat 2 and a flat 6. Similarly, you'll have another scale which could be the major scale with a sharp 4. And all these scales which you form, I think if I'm not mistaken, there are about 72 such scales, which is a ton of them, right? I don't think I've even gone through half of them. I hope I have, but man, it's a lot to learn, isn't it? So if you're in a shell where you're just using the major scale over and over and over again, because music theory textbook seems to give you all the information with the major scale. You harmonize the major scale, you form the major scale, the circle of fifths is for the major scale. So all your core theory is for the major scale. But why not go beyond? When you can go beyond, and when the major scale is just one out of the many, arguably 72 permutations. So in Indian music, they call these, in Carnatic, they say Melakarta Ragas, which are arguably 72 in number, or in Hindustani music, they call this as the Thaat system, where you build 7-note scales, and then under that, you can build subset scales out of that, which are ragas, as we say, right? And as always, this is Jason here from Nathaniel School of Music. And if you like the lesson, please don't forget to share the lesson. Turn on that bell icon for notifications. You'll get a lot more lessons coming your way from Nathaniel. And also subscribe if you haven't already. And what else can you do? You can also share the video. These are all the things you can do to support us, grow our channel, and bring more music to all of you people. So hope all of you have a lot of fun with this lesson. And I will see you in the next video. Cheers.